Hi, I'm Hugo from Botcity. In this video, I will show you how to automate any desktop applications. For that, I will use an open source business software called Factorama to demonstrate how easily you can create automations using Botcity framework and Botcity Studio. So this is Factorama main screen. Here you can have access to your documents, products, payments, shippings, and also register new products, which is where we're going to be focusing today. So to register a new product, we're going to click on this new product element. And after that, we're going to fill in all the fields that we have. Plus, we're going to select a picture and then save this new product in. So to get started, I have here on my VS Code the skeleton of a project. So the first thing that I'm going to do is open up Factorama. So for that, I'm going to use the execute command, followed by the path for the software, which I already have here. So let me just fix that. Done. I had it here. So after that, if we just save, let me close this, and we run this code, it's going to take a little bit of time because Factorama is a little bit of a heavy code to get started. So in a couple of seconds, yeah, there you go. We should see the splash screen. So it's checking the database. And there you go, we have the main screen. After that, for our code, what we're gonna do is we're gonna leverage Bot Studio to help us do the screenshots and the screen navigation via computer vision. So if I press print screen here, notice that Bot Studio already opened. I can click here. So it's now working side by side with my VS Code. So if I come to the UI tab, the very first thing that we're going to do is click on the new product button. So once I give the first click, it's going to zoom in. Then I can start selecting my area for the computer vision. So I'm going to get a nice tight fit. I'm going to call this new product button. And the action that I want to perform on this is a click. So I'm going to click submit. After that, we can see that the code was automatically generated for this particular event. So it's going to do a find on this image here of the new product, waiting time 10 seconds. Since I already know that Factorama takes a while to open, I'm going to bump this one to 60 seconds. That doesn't mean that the framework is going to wait for 60 seconds before anything else happens, but that's the maximum waiting time. So I'm going to move ahead and already start proceeding with the automation. So I know that once I click on new product, it's going to show up this new screen. So here, I just simply go ahead, use print screen again. Now the Botcity Studio already detected that my screenshot was updated. So I'm going to click on the item number. So I'm going to search for it as my anchor. So I'm going to call it item number. And instead of performing a find or a click, I'm going to click relative since I'm interested on the field by its side. Once that's done, I can save my code. And now I can go and work on my VS Code. So here, what I'm going to do is, now that I have the focus on the item number, I'm going to start filling up the information. So for that, I'm just going to paste some information that I have here. So my item number is going to be 1. After that, like we saw before, we can press tab and navigate to the next field, which is name. So with this, you can see that syntax is very user friendly and just like the regular language, you can say paste tab, and that is very nice. So I'm going to call it test product 1. After that, I'm going to go to the next field, which is category. So there, I'm gonna paste the value category 1. Then to the next one, which is the GTIN, where I'm gonna just give it the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So to the next one, which is the supplier. My supplier code is going to be 99. And then we arrive at the description. So the description is going to be, this is a nice test product, because why not? And now we arrive at an interesting case. So let's take a look what happens once we click on the price and we start filling up a value. So this field, different from the other ones, comes pre-filled with zero. So if I type 10 here, for instance, it really gives me 100 if I navigate to another one. So that means that not only we need to switch to this field, but first make sure that once we access it, we select all the information before typing. So for that, we can do a Control A to select all. Now we can safely paste our value here, let's say 1099. Then we can go to the next field, which is the cost price. So the same thing applies here. So for this one, we do again Control A to make sure that we select all. And then we paste our cost value, which in this case, I'm going to say is 299. Very nice profit margin here. We're going to skip the allowance and the VAT. We're going to leave it as is. So twice we're going to press tab, which is going to give us to the stock field. So like I said, if we come here, we put 299, press tab, and then we need one more to arrive at stock, which again, it's a field which already contains information. So we're gonna do Control A. And let's say for the sake of a test that we have 10 units of this product. Once that is done, we're interested in selecting a picture for our product. So for that, I'm gonna save the code, go back to my Botcity Studio. It automatically updates with the latest code that we changed on the VS Code. And here in the UI, I'm going to select this select a picture field in which we want to click on it. So the first click allows me to start the selection. So I can get a nice tight fit on the bottom right corner, go back to the top left, and I'm going to call this select picture. And here we're interested in just clicking on it. After that, now that we have our code for the select a picture, I know that if I click on this field using the Factorama, it's going to open up the system dialog for file selection. So just for the sake of simplicity, I'm just going to give it here a little wait time of a half a second. And after that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to paste the path to my image, since I know that this box comes already with the file name in focus. So that's going to be C and then product images / product1.png. With that, I know that if I press enter, it already going to go to the product that I have and select our picture. Once we are done with this portion, we're going to save our product. So for save, we're going to need to click on the save button there. So again, I press print screen. I go back to the Botcity Studio. I select where I want to inject the code. And then I look for my save button here. Again, the first click is going to zoom in. Second click allow me to start the selection. Then I click again and go back for a nice tight fit. I'm going to call this save BTN to be my save button. And I'm going to select the click. As easy as that, the code was generated. So if I click here and save, there it goes. The code is back on my VS Code. So now let's give it a try and see how that goes. So let me close Factorama here. Yes, I sure want to exit. I don't want to save this temporary product. Cool. Let's run and see what happens. It's just going to take a while to appear. So we're going to have first the splash screen, and then the framework is going to start looking for that new product button that we selected. So there goes the splash screen. And now we can see that is going to right-click on the new product button and start filling up the information as we select it. So there it goes. Selecting all first, make sure that we don't override anything. The select picture, there it goes, and click it on save. Just as that, we just registered a new product with Factorama. So that shows you how easy and fast it is. And with less than 50 lines of code, we managed to do this automation. But I want to show you something else here. So not only we can generate the code, but also another good feature of the Botcity Studio is that it allows us to document the interfaces. So in here, what I'm going to do to highlight this feature is I'm going to again do a print screen here to get a screenshot. And coming back on the Botcity Studio, what I'm going to do is use this other button on the side, which allows me to capture the screen. So I'm going to select it first here. You notice that it didn't zoom in because we want to do a big selection. And then I come back again to have a nice tight fit. And I'm going to call this main screen. Now, notice that it didn't ask us for an action. That's because we're using the documentation mode. So if we go back, it goes back, takes us back to the code. I can save it here. And notice that it injected now this image here. So that's going to help other developers coming afterwards to see what we were seeing on the time that we did this documentation and have a visual documentation of the code. On the VS Code side, on your favorite IDE, you can see that it just injects this little snippet that the Botcity Studio uses afterwards to render the proper image. So I'm going to add a new one here as well to document what we were able to see once we clicked on new product. So for that, I'm going to click here, new product, get a new screenshot, come back on the studio, click on the documentation tool, again, start my selection. And then I'm going to put here new product area. Clicking on submit, the same thing happened. Our code is now properly documented, and whoever comes after can take a look and really see why we followed this procedure. Well, I hope you liked it. That was the idea today to show you how easy it is to create desktop automations using the Botcity framework and the Botcity Studio. See you on the next one. Bye-bye.